hello, I'm MPX Toy Cat, and if you watch any Minecraft tutorial, under every single one of them, you'll find comments asking, is this the Bedrock or Java edition? And on the surface, this seems very logical. There are two entirely different versions of Minecraft that do look very similar and do have all of the same blocks, but the truth is, as someone who plays a lot of Bedrock, it's very clear to me immediately whether I'm looking at Bedrock gameplay or non-Bedrock gameplay, i.e. Java, and today I think it'd be fun to load up the Java edition, the one I don't play as much, and mention every single difference that I can find. I'll even set a timer for 20 minutes, and I guarantee in that time we'll have found a ludicrous number of differences that can help you work out whether you're watching Minecraft, Java, or Bedrock. If you'd like to see more of either edition, especially when it comes to updates, then make sure you subscribe with notifications turned on so you can see more of these videos on your homepage, by the way. But let's dive straight into the Java edition. Because obviously the menu screen is different. First of all, it says Java Edition right there. Second of all, it's got 5 menu options as opposed to 4, including these two little things over here, making it 7. Also, you can click on the bottom right, copyright Mojang AB, do not distribute, which, fun fact, takes you to the credits only on the Java Edition. But yeah, if we load up a new world and go past the new menu screen, difference number 4, you can see when you create a new world, there is a ton of different options. Namely, Hardcore is a world type. Actually, wait, is Hardcore? Hardcore is a game mode, apparently, my bad. Interestingly enough, you can also go to more world options, and there's a few unique ones. Generate structures is, if I'm not mistaken, unique to the Java version. It's also on the console edition, but that's been discontinued. And then the world types, super flat is unique to Java, at least if you customize it in any way. The single biome option is unique to Java. The caves world type is unique to Java. The floating islands is unique to Java, and man, this is just getting painful. So let's load up a world with a default seed with structures turned on, and let's show you what else you can spot, because again, there's a ton of different things we can do here. We could spend all day in the menu screen, but let's actually show you the game itself. So yeah, if you look at the hotbar, you can immediately see, assuming that you don't spot it, that's a pixel off, you can see that it's actually at the very bottom of the screen. Like, it's literally as far down as it can go. There is no space between the hotbar and the bottom of your screen. However, when you play the Bedrock, there's something like 5-10 pixels, a little bit of space just to account for any, weird screens that have overscan or underscan or whatever. And so it's very interesting that way. Also, what's interesting is if we take some damage, trust me, that was on purpose, you'll notice just how fast we heal up. This is a Java edition only thing. If on Bedrock you take damage, you always heal at the rate we're healing at now, where it takes half a heart. Yeah, again, we get half a heart every 4 seconds, I think it is. That is the only speed you can heal on Bedrock, unless you use golden apples or some other effect. Also quite interesting, if we do a little bit of sprinting around, you'll notice how in the top left, there is no I think it's called the 3D character, the ragdoll, something like that. There is no character showing me that I'm running around. If I want to see myself running, I have to go into third person, just like this. And so yeah, you can see it's very different. Also, you can tell that I'm playing the Java edition because I have a cape, the Minecon capes, and really every single cape in Minecraft besides the pan cape and the 1 year cape are exclusive to the Java edition, so that's kind of interesting. Also, what's exclusive in the reverse is you can't have custom geometry in the Java edition. So if I took off my cape, I guess I can't. But if you look at my skin, the mouth looks like it comes out a little bit, but it's just all, like textures. My mouth is actually the same depth as my face. Whereas if you look at a Bedrock skin, they can use 3D geometry, which means that my Bedrock skin, for instance, has a tail and has a weird sticking out mouth and actually has ears that aren't these weird one pixel wide things. And so there is another difference. And so already we found so many, but the list kind of continues on because I'm going to punch down a tree. This is a classic Minecraft thing. Also, you know we're going to come to that salmon later. But this is a classic Minecraft thing. The way you craft is different. I mean, it's kind of similar in this way, but the recipe book looks like this on the Java edition, whereas on Bedrock, it's got the tabs at the top. It doesn't have everything in there by default. It's a very different system for that. And yeah, also by default on Java, basically no one uses this. I know some people do, but most people don't. Whereas by default on Bedrock, this is enabled by default. So you'll see a lot more of this screen on Bedrock than you will on Java. Also quite interestingly is the fact that the character over here will follow where your mouse cursor is. So if I just show you with this, so you can actually see where my mouse is. If I move the spruce planks around, the toy cat is following where the planks are. He really wants to see those planks because he's going to craft them. Whereas on Bedrock, the same thing is not true. This actually causes a ton of bugs on Java, and I think it's worse than it is good. But it's very interesting that this is the case. It's very, very reactive. You can do some very insane things, and I think that's fun personally. But maybe you disagree. Speaking of things you might disagree about, the color of the water on Java is always exactly the same. Honestly, it's kind of boring if you go from Java to Bedrock, but it just all looks like this. There is a slight difference when you look at water in the distance, and I think the different ocean biomes biomes might have different colors of water, but if you're in a tiger biome or a forest or a swamp, all water looks exactly the same on you, and it's a little bit boring in my opinion. And you know what? I can't take it any longer. I need to talk about it. Notice these salmon right here. They're actually, they're delightful. There's no flaws in them. They definitely all look exactly the correct size for Minecraft. No, more seriously, Java salmon are all exactly the same size, whereas Bedrock salmon come in 3 sizes. Also, if you are to punch one of these guys to death, on the Java edition, they can only drop bone meal, whereas on Bedrock, obviously they drop bones themselves, which is 3 times as valuable. It does have to be worth mentioning. So I'm gonna keep punching one until I can get some bone meal, because yeah, that is a really big downgrade in my opinion. Also, the way you swim on the Java edition means that you can't swim at the surface. As you can see, if I go into third person, it might be easier. I can swim while I'm below the surface, but if I go too close to the surface, it just kind of stops you from... Oh, there we go. We can actually... That's the first time I've ever pulled it off successfully, actually. But it's really hard to swim near the surface. Also, as you're going to see while I try to punch this salmon, when you punch on the Java edition, there is this lovely little loading bar that shows you, like, yeah, when you have to wait until that bar goes away. Otherwise, you don't get the full damage from a punch. And so, yeah, now we've got some lovely salmon. I mean, it's not the same because it doesn't come from a big salmon, but it's almost as good. Also, in the bottom right, you can see the saving world text that is only seen on the Java edition. On the Bedrock, so there's an icon in a different place, and in the console, it's true too. The way the saving works across Java and Bedrock is very different, as you might expect, given that they're designed in different languages with very different save systems. The save files are entirely incompatible, it does have to be said. Speaking of things that have to be said, the Java edition tends to look a bit different to Bedrock, because your options for, like, again, you'll notice the render distance is always way lower. The highest render distance you can set by default, without Optifine, on the Java version is just 32 chunks, and even that, you're gonna notice it slows down our game a little bit. Even though we've got a 2080 Ti in this PC, it just, again, Java edition is a very CPU-constrained game. Actually, which, you know, results in some weird things like this. It's not very pleasant, and so most people play Minecraft with lower render distance, or they play with Optifine. If you see people do that weird thing where I'm gonna use video editing to pretend it's the same now, look, I'm zooming into this pillager tower right now, except I'm not actually zooming in, that was video editing. But when you see people do that in videos, it's almost always Java, because Optifine has that included, and Optifine is the most popular Java mod and does not exist on Bedrock. Also, that's why you'll notice more capes on Java, because that mod allows you to do some weird stuff with capes. But yeah, if you see capes at all that aren't the Pan cape or the Minecon live cape, I think it is, then you know that you're seeing Java. So just to reiterate that one fact. Speaking of reiterating facts, the food system on Java sucks. It's great for healing when you have a lot of food in you, but when you have very little food, let me show you why food sucks. Every time you heal up hearts, outside of using your saturation, you lose some hunger at the exact same time. If I eat this one salmon, as you can see, I get, like, I think it's 2 free heals just because I ate salmon. And then every single healing half heart that I use takes a half heart from my hunger bar. It's really, really hard to heal up because you need to eat a ton of food. I mean, it's a little ridiculous, right? I just want to have full health. Is that so much to ask? Minecraft Java says yes. Yes, it is. Okay, so here's another fun one, right? How many hits do you think it should take to kill a cow? Bear in mind that a cow has 10 hit points. If you're playing the Java edition, obviously we're using our fist here for this. I'm gonna die. I don't think I can do anything about that pillager. Okay, let's come back when we've got an actual defense mechanism. Oh God, I'm being surrounded. I'm just gonna jump in the sea. I could be wrong, but I think I'll confirm on screen. The fact that the pillager only hurt me for 2 hearts means that's another confirmation of Java. They do way more damage on Bedrock. Or not way more, but I believe it's different. Fact check, Harrison. So yeah, combat is a lot more difficult on Java because you have to make sure you time your hits. However, combat is easier on Bedrock in the early game because obviously instead of taking 10 hits to kill this cow, it takes 5. Your fist does 2 damage on the Bedrock edition, whereas it does 1 damage on Java, and that's 1 damage when it's fully charged, which is a very interesting difference. Anyway, so now let's take these cows that we've murdered in cold blood. By the way, notice when I punch the cow, he runs away manically, which is, again, if I'm not mistaken, a manic Java feature only. They're pretty chill about it by comparison on the Bedrock edition. So the way that cows react is a good way to test this one. Okay, so I'm barely surviving right now. I'm gonna be honest with you. I wanna show you what happens when you cook up the raw beef, because obviously, this is a fun difference between versions, but also, just hit real quick, because again, this whole video is in survival, I want to show you legit. So, there are 2 big differences between igloos on the Java edition and the Bedrock. The first one is the bed. The bed is a red bed. Oh, we can't sleep because there are monsters nearby. And the second is the ice behind this redstone torch. When we activate this furnace, what's going to happen, to cook our beef, by the way, what's going to happen is the light level from the furnace is high enough that it will melt ice. On the Bedrock Edition, it's made from blue ice, and so it doesn't melt so easily, which is both a good and a bad thing, depending on your perspective, I guess. But yeah, that means that, we can finally eat the item, because when you cook raw beef on the Java Edition, you get steak. When you cook it on the Bedrock Edition, you get cooked beef. What is the actual difference there? Who knows for sure? But look at this healing. This is the clear way you can tell when you're playing Java. When you eat good food, steak, when you eat golden carrots or whatever other foods like that, you really notice it much better. And so you can heal much faster on the Java Edition, which is a big, big difference. Okay, I'm gonna run out of here now. This is clearly not working for me otherwise. Oh, another difference. If you look at the icon for the bed in the inventory, you can see that it's way more slanted. On Bedrock, it looks like this. Why is it different? I don't know. Also, I'm gonna sleep between two villages. Oh, damn it. What is nearby? What monster is ruining my sleep? I hear him, but I don't see him. Oh, there he is. Okay, perfect. So yeah, notice my full health. Notice, by the way, also, the sweeping edge, like, you see that little swipe that was on screen a second ago? I'll do a quick instant replay for you. That little effect is actually exclusive to the... Also, look at the way you sleep. It's very different between versions. That is an effect that is exclusive to the Java Edition. You can attack multiple enemies at once. This is the one balancing factor on the fact that you can only attack once every second or so. And yeah, it's kind of like the fully charged thing. It's pretty cool. I like it a lot. I think it's a... I think it's the one big benefit of Java's weird combat system. Speaking of weird benefits of the Java combat system, I actually don't know where I'm going to take that one. Notice how this is a golem, and if I punch the golem, he gets a little bit injured. I mean, I should dig myself a hole. Let's get out of here, right? Let's go down and try not to die. I'm dead. It's over. So notice as I punch the golem, he slowly gets injured, and you can see the texture change. Look how it's... Okay, well... note, by the way, here's a weird one that's exclusive to the Java Edition, if I let the golem kill me again. So yeah, when the golem kills me again, as he's gonna do, as you can see, not only does it show me dying, Toycat was slain by Iron Golem, title screen and respawn, it also gives me a score. Java Edition, invented this like 10 years ago, added a score feature that's very mysterious and weird. Why does it exist? No one knows. No, I don't know a single person who's ever used this, non-ironically, but there is a score on your screen. Speaking of things that are on your screen, there's another thing you might notice. If we play Minecraft right now, if we do something intense, like we need a split second to decide, let's say we punch an Iron Golem and we don't know how to react, Minecraft Java Edition is by default a offline game. It is a game that you play by yourself. You can open it to LAN and there's a lot of cheating that can go on there. However, if we try to do the exact... Okay, so right now, I'm in an intense situation. I punched an Iron Golem. I want to get out of there. What you can do is you can pause the game because it's an offline game meant for single players. If I open to LAN, then it becomes an online game, but most people don't do that. Whereas Bedrock by default is a multiplayer game. This means that even when you play Bedrock by yourself, when you pause the game, it doesn't actually pause. You're just opening the options, I guess, is the difference there. Whereas you can actively pause Minecraft Java. Also, speaking of weird differences, instead of achievements, they're called advancements, and it looks like this. It's pretty fun. Also, unlike achievements, when you accomplish one of these, you get some experience. I think it's only the higher end ones you get experience for. But if you kill, for instance, if we go to Adventure Time, you actually get an experience number that I'll show on screen because I don't know what it is. You get experience for all sorts of things on the Java Edition, which is a really cool in-game reward. Whereas on the Bedrock Edition, you're only rewarded out of the game with the achievement, which some would argue is better. Although actually also on Bedrock, you get the character creation thing. Also on Bedrock, you can change your skin midway through the game. There's a little button right here that doesn't exist. Also on Bedrock, you see a list of players only when you pause. On Java, you press the tab, but only when you're online. Also on the Bedrock Edition, obviously everything looks different here. The whole menu screen, everything about it is massively different. The options menu is different. There are more controls for the music and sound options on the Java Edition than the Bedrock Edition. It's much more intense. Subtitles are one of my, if you ever watch a speedrunning stream, this is how you know if it's Java or Bedrock. You can tell, okay, so it's gonna tell me like zombie groans. Actually, I couldn't even hear that zombie groaning, and that's why it's so useful. It tells you which direction something's happening in, which your ears might not be properly accustomed to. This is honestly, if developers are serious about Bedrock speedrunning, I think this is one they need to implement, because it is a huge benefit to Java players. I mean, honestly, when I watch like TV shows and movies, I watch with subtitles, I feel like I'm getting an advantage on the TV show. Like, yeah, you might have missed that little joke in the background, but I know it because I got the subtitles. And I think we have just... Okay, we got 1 full minute. What can we do now? We can talk about how the villagers, if they're babies, they look entirely different over here on the Java edition. It's like genuinely weird to me. Like, are there any baby villagers around? I don't know if there are. What we can talk about also is bells. This is a weird one to me. If you ring the bell when there are pillagers around on the Java edition, it will highlight those villagers, whereas there is no highlighting spectral effect at all on the Bedrock version. Also, if we eat some rotten flesh, the effects menu is different. On Bedrock, you have to press Z and there's a special effects menu. On Java, it's part of the inventory screen. If you have this open, it just shows a little square. If you don't have it open, it shows you it there. Java has a much better screen for this, in my opinion, rather than having to have a special effects only screen. It's kind of weird and strange. Speaking of weird and strange, I believe we hit the 20 minute timer, and so anything after that does not count. How many differences did we find? Let's tally them up. I think they've been counting this whole video. Wow, it's that many. I totally know what that number is because we're not using editing to count it all up, and I totally wasn't busy recording instead of counting them all in my head. But yeah, it's a very big number, I think. There are so many other differences between the two games. The way lava looks, the way caves generate, the way almost everything is very distinctly different. If we, you know, the way commands work, we can actually type /seed, and as long as we do it in all lowercase, it will just tell us the seed, which, by the way, the seed is then much longer, and you can copy it straight to your clipboard, by the way. It is really, really cool to see all of the differences, and the moment you become aware of just a few of these, you can hopefully get a good idea of whether you're watching Java or Bedrock, and therefore whether that tutorial applies to just the Java or just the Bedrock version. Because, for instance, redstone is massively different. For instance, the way you should approach PvP and even speedrunning and, you know, PvE and the dragon and the wither, it varies so much from version to version, and I hope this video raised just a little bit of awareness about that. And if it didn't, then I hope you enjoyed it anyway. By the way, if you'd like to be as important to me as subtitles are for the speedrunning community, make sure that you subscribe, maybe with notifications turned on, and if you really, really liked it, consider becoming a member with that join button, where you can get access to quite a few exclusives, including me bathing in Iron Brew. Why is that an exclusive member-only video? Why is that a video is the better question, but yeah, I hope you all enjoyed, because I'll see you tomorrow, probably. Goodbye!